Welcome back, guys. It's Edie, your video and YouTube strategist, and I'm coming in today to give you guys an update on the last video that I did here, how to use Loom video recorder that I did about 8 months ago. And since then, Loom has now improved upon this platform and now has a pro version, which is a standalone version. It's not necessary for you to use it through the Chrome extension. And I just wanted to come in today and walk you through how to use that. So in order for you to get started and use Loom Pro, you need to go on to useloom.com, go into your account, and under your icon of your avatar, you can see Explore Loom Pro. And when you click on that, it will tell you what the price of Loom Pro is going to be. You can do it still for free, so there's still that option. But just understand that you're only going to have standard quality video, and it's going to max you out at 100 videos. In order for you to take advantage of all of the pro features, you'd need to upgrade to, if you're doing this on a monthly basis, $10 a month. But if you want to pay for it annually, it will work out to $8 a month, which essentially will get you 2 months for free. So what are you going to get with the pro version? You're going to get high quality video, so it's going to be HD. You're going to get unlimited storage, so you already know that Loom stores all of your videos on its platform. You're going to get some more fancified recording tools, as well as you're going to be able to edit your videos. So you can start off with a free trial just to kind of get a lay of the land to see whether or not this is something that you want to upgrade to, or you can just go straight ahead and upgrade to it. So what I want to do now is just actually walk you through that platform. So once you've downloaded the app onto your desktop, you can just click on it and that will open up the app for you. Now, because this is still fairly new, they do update this application pretty much daily, if not at least every couple of days. So you are going to need to download and install the latest update more often than not before you start using the platform. For the purpose of time, I'm actually going to skip this download and install. But I want you to see that the window that opened up here is very similar to the window that would open up in your Chrome extension. As you can see, you have three ways of recording. You can record your screen and your camera, or you can record your screen only, or you can record your camera only. Now, just so that you understand, the reason why this is just spooling and nothing is happening is because in order for me to do this tutorial, I needed to use another screen recording application so that I could really show you all of the benefits within Loom Pro. So since I'm using Camtasia and I'm using the camera on Camtasia, both cameras can't work, or the same camera can't work for both applications. So that's why you see this spooling. But typically I would appear down here in the corner. Here is where you would adjust for that information on whether or not you want to switch cameras, or if you don't want to have any. And because I did that, you can see that it went away. And then it's going to allow you to choose which microphone, and then you can see that your audio levels are fine. Now, under where it shows your microphone, you can see that it's telling you what your internet speed is. So it's letting you know that you have very fast internet speed. In order for you to really get all the benefits of Loom Pro, it is recommended that you have really good internet speed. So over here, you can adjust what kind of quality you're going to have. So as you can see, it starts at 1080p. I can go down if I wanted, which I wouldn't, but I can also go up to 4K. So that is a huge difference between Loom Pro and the Loom Chrome extension version that we've been using up until now. So when you're ready to start to record, all you need to do is click on the Start Recording button. So once you click on the Start Recording button, because I have two monitors, it's asking me which one would I like to record. So I can choose whichever monitor I want. If you only have one computer, it's only going to show you that one desktop. So I'll say that I want to record the screen that I'm on right now. It gives you the countdown, and then you can start recording. You'll notice over here that the record button stays present and stays visible on your screen. Here's a quick tip to show you how you can remove that record button. You need to come up here to these three dots, go to Preferences, and then under Recording, you want to make sure that this is off, because you really want to have your desktop clean and only have the things that you want to record on it. So over here, when you hover over the record button, this is your stop record button. This is if you wanted to pause. This is if you wanted to delete it. And then now you have an annotation feature, if you will. If you wanted to draw on the screen, you can now do this. My cursive isn't that great. After a period of time, it does disappear. You can adjust the thinness or the thickness of your, that's very thick. And then if you go down there, it's very thin. You can also change the color if you like. And when you're finished, you can just click on done. So when you're finished with this recording, you would just click on the record button. That will then automatically open up Loom like it did before. So there are no changes with regards to that. It then shows you what you've recorded. You have the capability of coming down here and changing your title of the video. You always will have your copy link here if you just want to run and go. But this over here is what I want to introduce you to, are the new features in Loom Pro. So I want you to pay particular attention to what's over here where it says edit video. You can still edit your video. You can still do your trims. That hasn't changed. What has changed and had been added for the Pro version is you can now add a call to action and you can add a custom thumbnail. So what am I talking about? For the call to action, it's literally a button. So if this is a video where, say for example, you're sending it to a client and you want the client to be able to book an appointment with you right after they see this video, you can put the text, book your appointment. Then you can type in the link that you want that person to go to. Then you can choose your color codes for it. And then you just click on save. Now it's not gonna let me do that, so let me just type in my Now the other thing that you can do is you can add a custom thumbnail. So what would that look like? All you would need to do is click on there. You can upload your thumbnail or you can drag and drop it. So let me find a thumbnail that I can drag and drop. And it comes over, voila. We can then save it. You can make any adjustments that you needed to make to it, but we'll just save this. And there you go. So when you play the video,
you can start recording.
Let's do this. You will see your call to action is here. And when you click on it, I have this going to my website. It will then take you to your website. And don't forget, you can change your title here. And then if you need to edit, you can trim here. And I don't need to go through that because you've been able to do that before. Okay, so I just wanted, oh, and then now under settings, okay. So another new feature, let's pause this. Another new feature is, okay. So the new features that you can see is that now you have settings. So under settings, you'll be able to see comments, turn them on or off. You can get email notifications of your comments. You can allow for the viewer to react to your video using emojis. That's if you want to do that. You can also use Loom's branded player. You can click on use as a default, or you can turn it off. You can have the viewer download your video or perhaps turn it off. And then you can show analytics to the video, to the viewer, meaning that they can see how many people have seen it, where have they reacted to it, and things of that nature. So you have the ability to turn on and off these things. And so you just click save. And then if you want to password protect this video, you can do so by typing in what the password would be. So that's totally up to you. All right, guys, thanks. Hope you found the video helpful. If you did, please share it, like it, and comment below. And I also would like to know, if you're using Loom Pro, what are your thoughts? Have you been able to use it in your business? And last but not least, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Take care, and I'll see you later.